My favorite office suite, LibreOffice, recently updated to version 7.2 and also added some new features. So LibreOffice Calc is what I have open here. This is probably the program out of the office suite that I use the most. This, and sometimes I use LibreOffice Impress to make slideshows at my job, because that's the most effective way to get executives to spend money on something, is explain to them why you need them to spend the money via slideshow. And LibreOffice Writer, which is probably the most well-known and most used LibreOffice program. I don't really use it too much these days, but I used to use it a whole lot back when I was in school. In fact, that's actually how I first got started using LibreOffice, was Writer for writing essays and different types of things I had to do for school. But mostly because you're able to save your documents as a docx. Like, I didn't have Microsoft Word when I was in high school, and I wasn't about to go pay for it. Like, that just seemed, I don't know, it seemed so stupid even to me as a kid, before I was like really into the whole idea of free software, just, you know, paying for software for the monetary purposes, and especially for having to write essays. Like, that's dumb. I didn't want to do that. But anyway, this is Calc, and first thing you probably notice is this fat mouse cursor that I have, like this, what is it, chubby cross or fat cross? I forget exactly what they call it, but this is, looks very similar to Excel. Like, this is just kind of the cursor theme that you get in Microsoft Excel. So I'm really glad that they added it to LibreOffice. Mine does look a little bit weird, like around the edges. I don't know if it's just, I'm guessing it's some kind of rendering issue, because that's not how it's supposed to look. So hopefully yours looks cooler than mine. Anyway, the way that you would enable this is by going to Tools, Options, and if you come to this drop-down LibreOffice Calc and then click on View, and just change your cursor to themed, and then that'll give you the chubby cross instead of just having a regular cursor. You know, it might make you feel a bit more at home if you're used to how Excel looks. There's also an option to now select visible rows and visible columns. So that is under Edit, and we go to Select, select visible rows only, and select visible columns only. So this is really useful if you have a spreadsheet with hidden rows or columns, and you want to select a large chunk of cells that are in between those hidden rows or columns without accidentally selecting the data that's in them, which you probably don't want if it's hidden. And Calc can now also filter by color in the auto filter. And the filtering can be done by both the text color and the cell background. And there's also some fixes to spreadsheet functions like raw subtract and round, as well as just performance improvements to formulas that are using VLOOKUP, and a lot of improvements to how quickly large Excel SX files can be opened, scrolled through, and filtered. That's something that I'm really excited for, because most of the customer cut sheets that I receive are still usually being saved in XLSX. Sometimes they get saved in CSVs, which is actually the format I need to run it through the programs I use at work. But anyway, when they come to me, sometimes I actually do have to use Microsoft Word to open them if they're just super, super big. Like, some of our customers, they have huge numbers of new users that they're activating, so it can get a little bit crazy. But maybe once I install 7.2 onto my work laptop, I will be able to use LibreOffice more often, and maybe I can finally get away from using Excel ever. Now, there's also a trailer on LibreOffice's channel, on the Document Foundation's channel, basically showing off some of the new features in LibreOffice 7.2. And this is probably one of the cleanest. themes for Impress look really nice. I really think that they will help with swaying executive decisions via slideshow. But probably one of the biggest things that I didn't really see mentioned in that video, well, I guess other than just briefly, is the amount of compatibility work that was done in this last version of LibreOffice. So you probably already know this, but LibreOffice is nowhere near the most popular Office suite. Microsoft Office still holds that title with Google, Google Office Suite, I think that's what they call it, being the close second. And Microsoft has some proprietary file formats, which unfortunately are still being used a lot, like Doc, XLS, and PPT. Now, using this is totally avoidable because there are open source versions of those file formats like DocX and XLSX, which do pretty much the same things, but open source. So Office Suites, other Office Suites can actually use them and have documents turn out looking the same way when they get open. But those proprietary extensions, they do still show up from time to time. And there's nothing worse than figuring out you have to create a Microsoft account and then sign into Office 365 to collaborate on a document that was saved in an old doc format. Maybe having to create a Google account to collaborate on Google Docs is just as painful from the not wanting to use proprietary software perspective, but there is a better chance that you at least already have a Google account instead of a Microsoft account. So maybe there's a little bit less pain there. LibreOffice 7.2 makes a lot of improvements there, which, like I was saying earlier, hopefully makes it more viable for me to just use it full time and not have to switch between occasionally using Microsoft tools. Also, LibreOffice 7.2 is now available natively on Apple Silicon. I don't know if versions before that were ported to the M1 MacBooks yet or not. I don't really have that hardware, and I typically don't keep up too much on Apple's ecosystem since I'm not involved in it, but if you do have one of those Macs, you can now use LibreOffice on it, so that's pretty cool. Anyway, to download LibreOffice, just head on over to LibreOffice.org, and you can click on this download tab and go to download LibreOffice, and it's going to use a little bit of nifty browser fingerprinting to determine what OS you're on, and it's going to automatically recommend for you the best way to download it, which for Linux would be to just install it through dpkg, or you could just install it through your package manager if it actually has this version, because it just came out. I guess Arch users will probably have it, so you can go ahead and install it through Pacman. And there's also an option to install it via Snap or Flatpak if you're a GNU/Linux user, but also hate yourself. Go ahead and check out the new version of LibreOffice. Let me know what your favorite new feature was in the comment section, or just say whatever to boost the algorithm, along with leaving a like and sharing. Have a great day.